Greetings everyone, my name is Icha. In this video I will be talking about honor killing. I will be focusing upon what exactly honor killing is and what are the laws which are being made to curb the same. Honor killing is the murder of a woman or a girl by the male family members. They justify the action by stating that the victim, that is the woman, has brought dishonor upon the family name or prestige. For instance, divorcing or separating from their spouse, refusing to enter into arranged child or forced marriage, having premarital or extramarital sex, becoming the victim of rape, sexual assault, etc. It is believed that a woman's chastity and fidelity through segregation and control is the responsibility of the men whom she belongs. A woman's illicit relationship, which goes against the societal norm, is believed to have defamed the family honor. A man, in order to safeguard his family's honor, and kill those who damaged it. Honor killing practiced in India at a much higher rate is because of the fact that the caste system continues to be its rigid best, and people who belong from the rural areas refuse to change their attitude towards marriage. According to them, if their daughter dares to disobey their parents and decides to marry a man of her wish but from another gotra or outside her caste, it would bring disgrace to the family's honor, and so they decide to kill them. What are the reasons for prevalence of honor killing? First, patriarchal mindset. Honor is a term which is always linked with the woman of the family. Starting from the way a woman dresses to person she marries is linked to the honor of the family. Her rights, will and even choices are considered as going against the societal norms and traditions. Second, caste system. Honor killing still remains in practice due to the rigidity of the caste system. They fear that they will lose their caste status through which they get many benefits. This makes them commit such a heinous crime. Third, caste panchayats. Caste panchayats are not in favor of couples who marry within the same gotra and violate societal norms. They encourage honor killing, which is considered illegal and unconstitutional. Fourth, lack of education. Illiteracy and lack of awareness of rights to freedom and constitutional rights to safeguard their protection from exploitation are the primary reason for rising of crime. Fifth, prevalence of several customary evil practices such as sati, where the life of women was taken away without their permission and consent. Committing adultery. Violence against women's autonomy in all matters of sexuality and marriage is one of India's most widespread and tenacious form of gender violence. Low status of women. In India, the women are considered as a divine force, but the multicultural Indian society placed women at different positions. Thus, there is no uniform status of women in Indian society. The status of women is low because of the patriarchal system. No separate laws have been made to curb honor killing. In spite of increasing cases of honor killing, it is still not recognized in Indian laws. People who commit honor killing consider this act as a part of their culture, thinking that they are protecting the honor of their family, not realizing they are promoting a heinous crime. Chauvinist men justify using aggression and violence on women in fear of losing their and their family's honor. It is believed that the idea behind such an act is that men maintain their supremacy in the society. Now coming to laws to curb honor killing. Honor killing comes under the ambit of Section 299 of Indian Penal Code, that is culpable homicide, and Section 300 of Indian Penal Code, that is murder. As it involves killing of a particular person, especially women, and the punishment for the same is life sentence or death penalty and fine. Section 120A and 120B of Indian Penal Code penalizes any person who is a party to a criminal conspiracy. Article 34 and 35 penalizes criminal acts done by several persons in furtherance of common intention. Honor killing takes away the life and dignity of women and are subjected to and inhumane treatment. International law urges the states to protect women from gender-based violence and to disqualify the term honor as a legal defense for the acts of violence against women. The Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women requires the state to grant equality to women before the law, including equal legal capacity and the ability to exercise that capacity in civil matters. It requires the state to provide legal protection for women's rights on an equal basis with men and to guarantee the effective protection of women against discrimination through competent national courts. As per Article 12 of International Convention on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, state parties take all these steps to ensure the right of women to the enjoyment of the highest attainable standard of physical and mental health. Crimes of honor that involve sexual and mental violence or physical or mental torture obstruct the right of women to enjoy the highest attainable standard of health. India, as a state party, is therefore legally obligated to ensure that the individuals and victims of crimes of honor are able to avail this right. The Constitution of India provides for certain basic fundamental rights that are available to all citizens, irrespective of caste, sex, race and gender. There are certain constitutional rights that are being violated due to commission of this act. Article 14, that is right to equality. Article 15, prohibition of discrimination on the grounds of religion, race, caste, sex or place of birth. Article 19, that is freedom of speech and expression. Article 21, right to life and personal liberty. Article 14 and 15, the Indian Constitution talks about equality before law and equal right before law, which means each and every citizen of India shall be treated equally without any discrimination on the grounds of caste, sex, creed, race, etc. But in the case of honor killing, women are being murdered, which forms gender violation. Article 19 and 21 of Indian Constitution talks about the right to freedom and right to life and personal liberty respectively. In the case of honor killing, the right to freedom is being violated. It is the freedom of every citizen to choose their life, where no person has the right to infringe and compel the citizen as per the wish of others. Every citizen has a right to life and liberty, which is the most important fundamental right. No person has the right to take away one's life. In this case, where the victim is being killed, it is subjected to violation of right to life and personal liberty. If we take a famous case of Shakti Vahini versus the Union of India, the Supreme Court stated that two consenting adults do not need the consent of their families and elders to get married. Further, any attempt of the Ka Panchayat or any other body to suppress their wishes to marry each other is illegal. At the end, I would like to conclude by saying, India needs new laws to tackle the so-called honor crimes, which attempt to control the woman's sexuality. Thank you.